Thank you for January. Thank you for February. Thank you for March. Thank you for April. Thank you for May. Thank you for June. We give you the glory for July. We magnify you for August. We adore you for this September. We magnify your goodness. It has been only you, God. It has been only you. You are the reason why we are not consumed. You are the reason why we are not destroyed. In you we live and move and have our peace. You are the breath of our life. We give you the glory. We magnify you. In Jesus' name we are praying. Join your hands with somebody. We want to pray. I want to pray 5 prayer points. You are going to say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, we thank you. On behalf of all our men in this church. For your grace and protection over their lives. Open your mouth and thank God. Let's pray for all our women, all our sisters in this church. Let's thank God for his hand upon their lives. All through the year. Shall we pray in the name of Jesus Christ? In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's thank God for all our students. Let's thank God because even in the academics they will move forward. Let's thank God because all things will begin to work for their good. Let's open our mouth and thank God in the name of Jesus. Pray in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. We give a praise. We give a praise. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's thank God for all our singles and youth in this church. For the hand of the Lord upon their lives. Shall we pray in the name of Jesus Christ? Father, we thank you for our singles and youth. Thank you for your hands upon the lives of everyone. Father, we thank you. Jesus is your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's stand up for all our workers, both government workers and artisans. Let's thank God for his hand upon their work. Let's open our mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying. Finally, we are going to thank God for Nigeria. Let's thank him for his hand upon this country. The peace, the tranquility. Open your mouth and thank God in the name of Jesus.
Nigeria. and that will go on. Some of you are not people, and you're not a lot of people. I'm not going to be back to the lady. God, I'm here.
In Jesus' name we are praying. Father, this first Sunday, our Sunday of Thanksgiving.
Baba,
we are thankful to you. For all that you have done. For all that you are doing. In Jeremiah 30 verse 19, you say, out of them shall come the voice of thanksgiving. And of them that make merry.
Say,
I shall multiply them.
There
it shall not be few. I shall glorify them.
Also.
For out of them shall call their governors and their
nobles.
Father, we thank you today as the church. We are not complaining like the world. We are thankful for everything. This morning I told the workers.
No,
even in the ugly situation, God is still in it. For He's working for our good. Father, we thank you.
Baba,
we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. In it all, we still say we thank you. Your word said in all things we should give thanks. Thank you, Father.
Baba,
blessed be your name. In Jesus' name we are praying. God bless you. Take your seat. I don't have time much today. The time is fast. This is our month of mental empowerment. And the media department also, they are doing a very good work. Is it media now? Media, they are doing well. In fact, many a time before we cross into the new month, I will just come here and meet it. So this month is our month of mental empowerment.
But
today I'm not going to be touching that. I've touched a little of that on Tuesday. And I touched the difference between the spirit, soul, and body. How that when you have a negative habit you have been struggling with. It's not usually a problem of the spirit. That is why you fasted and prayed. It didn't change. So I've told them, I said, that teaching will change a lot of things in our life. In fact, it will reveal the secret of working miracles and hearing the voice of God clearly. With ease. Are you hearing me? You're not hearing me.
Oh, boy, man.
For example, yesterday in the school of discipleship, I told them 12 ways the Holy Spirit speaks to us. We actually touch 5 out of 12. And I told them that's what you call sense knowledge. Yes, and that's what you call spiritual knowledge. So you need to know how to distinguish the two. So that you'll not be missing things. And I told people, I said, this teaching this morning is one thing anybody should not miss for anything. Because it is the complement of every other thing. God bless you. Today God gave me a word that I would like to share in a moment. I will be closing this service very soon. I will be preaching, not teaching. Though it may result like it may end up becoming like teaching. And by the grace of God today, open that Joshua, and Joshua will read for me chapter 7.
Yes, give
me verse 11. I picked my topic from verse 11. Actually, we read from verse 1 to 13. Israel had sinned, and they have also transgressed my covenant which I commanded them, for they have even taken of their accursed thing, and have also stolen and dissembled also, and they have put it even among their own stuff. And so my topic this morning that the Lord has laid in my heart is, what are you hiding? What are you hiding in your stuff? That is the express word I received very early this morning. And it kept coming in a very strong way. And I want you to hear me very well. Today some of you know why your prayers are not answered. Some of you see what is stopping the move of God in your life. Help me tap your neighbor. Say, what are you hiding in your stuff? What are you hiding in your stuff? That means what are you hiding in your possession? When Adam fell, he hid himself. The nature of the fallen man is to hide something. What are you hiding in your stuff? Now the story we read in Joshua chapter 7 showed us the people of God. The Lord told Joshua when he came to leadership that no man will be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Look at me, God is a covenant keeping God. I had known him for a few years, but I know he doesn't break his word. Listen to me. He is not a truth breaker. That means he's not a covenant breaker. The Bible says he's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. What he said, he will do. Somebody listening to me. Hear me very well. He told Joshua.
Oh, so for Joshua.
In the Bible, there are about 25 personalities in the Bible that are symbolic with the person of Jesus. There are people that are like Jesus. About 25 of them. One of them is Joshua. Actually, the word Joshua is the Hebrew rendition of the Greek Jehoshua. It means savior. Joshua is synonymous to Jesus.
Joshua, the
same meaning. Jehoshua and Jesus means the same thing.
Jehoshua ati Jesus.
It means the savior. Is somebody hearing
me?
And God said to Joshua, no man. Everybody say no man.
You'll
be able to stand before you all the days of your life. But it got to a point, they look as though God has reversed his word. There are many of you who are looking at yourself that is the promise of God still true about healing? I have been sick. I have prayed. I have even believed God. And it's not happening in my life. I did things, what they asked us to do. Yet I can't see God. And you have been asking questions. Is God still true? Is God still there? Where is his bowels of mercy? You have been asking questions. The question Gideon asked the angel of God. That Gideon asked the angel of God. He said, we had our fathers told us. And where is his power like of old? Where is his miracles that our father told us? Many of you have been asking questions. Where is the God of the Bible? I came to announce to you that he is still alive. As I'm talking to you, he's even here with us. Is somebody hearing
me?
But where is the missing link? They just attack a city. And that city is called
Jericho.
It was a city. It was the first city Israel met after they left Egypt. The size of the wall of Jericho. History told us if four chariots ride on it, they will not touch each other. The weight is almost equal to a federal express road. That was the size, the weight of the wall of Jericho. They came across that wall.
and the finger of Yeshua, Amasiah.
Joshua, to
he pulled the wall down and defeated the whole city. After the city of Jericho, they came across the little village and Joshua said, all of us should not go. From the record we read in the Bible, the Bible says 600,000 men.
Egbeta,
don't know Egberu. 600,000 men. Who can fight the war? They didn't count the women and the children and the
men.
Came out of Egypt. And Joshua said, we should not send all our armies to what? To this small country, less than 3,000 men. For you to know how small I was. Play that thing for me, brother. He was to go and, they were to go and finish
Ai.
But Israel fell before
Ai.
36 men were killed. And Joshua went on his face. And he cried to the Lord. Lord, what had happened? What will the nation say? Who have heard about what you have done to us? If you know the God of
Israel,
you will know that every nation that heard that Israel was coming were terrified. They were terrified. There was no battle they did not win. But hear what God said to Joshua. He said, from henceforth, Israel will not be able to stand before his enemies. And neither can my presence go with you. Listen to me. You may lose anything, not lose the presence of God. Every tap your neighbor. Say, what are you hiding in your store? Hear
me.
That is something you are hiding that will keep God's presence from you. Why are we praying about enemies? And they are still ever with us. Why are we praying about battles? And they refuse to go. Ask your neighbor, what are you keeping in your store? There are some things when you keep it in your life, it will keep God out of your life. God is not a respecter of person. He even respects his own work.
The
Bible says he exalts his word above his name. Is not a respecter of person. I don't care the prophet prophesying over your life, including this pastor. The word of God is superior to
God.
Somebody hearing me? I looked through my Bible. I saw some people who kept some things hidden in their store. And I saw their end. I saw Kiasi. A man who was covetous. He kept covetousness. He was supposed to inherit from a man who received a double portion. There were two problems with Gehazi. He was covetous. And he has no reference for his prophet. I discovered that the punishment over keeping and hidden stuff. This punishment is usually generational. This one we read. He died with his children. He suffered with his children. I saw Gehazi, who became leprous with his family and children. As I
journeyed
in the Bible, I came across another man called Judas. He walked with Messiah. He saw the miraculous. He saw the power of God. Like
Gehazi,
he was also covetous. He also dishonored his prophet. When he laid the poured an oil and perfume.
come upon his master. He was saying, what waste is this? On my master.
No,
what a waste is this? He said, this could have been sold. And the money into the treasury. And the Bible said, it was not because he loved the poor, but because he steals from the money. I saw how generations are wasted.
Why?
Because there are some things in their stores. As I continue, I saw a person like Samson. In mighty Nazarene of God. If I was any man that walked under the spirit of the Lord and the spirit of might, a man that would take the jawbone of an ass and heap upon heaps 1,000 Philistine soldiers, a man that can remove the city gate. I saw how he was wasted because of his love for women. What are you hiding in your store? It's an idol that is waiting to ruin your future. Anything you hide today will finish your future. What are you hiding in your store? I continue my journey. I see a person like Rachel. Rachel. I saw Rachel. The case of Rachel embittered my heart. The beloved wife of Jacob. The beloved man or wife of a man called Israel. From whose generation the 12 tribes were divided. She had a delay. Because God was to give her children that grow big generation. Can I prophesy to you? You are coming to the world to not put your generation in problem. You are called to be a blessing. Yes, shahada. God has ordained you a blessing. I want you to know. You will not become a curse. Lisa Kaparusa Vinha. Rachel. She left her father's house with her husband. That's not the problem. But she took the idol of her father. And the Bible said she hid it in her store. Even her husband did not know. And listen to me, the Lord said to me as he was speaking to me this morning. He said, because she took her father's idol, the forces of her father's house came after her. Why is the generational spirit pursuing you? With all deliverance, you are hiding their store in your belongings. You cannot take the idol of your father's house and the spirit of your father's house will not
fail.
Some of you, the idol of your father's house is stubbornness. Everybody in your generation is stubborn. For some is lying. For some is anger. For some is stealing. It's a generational thing. You cannot carry the idol of your father's house. And the spirit of your father's house will not come after you. Laban came after them. He said, if you must go, go. Why must you take my God? If you want to be born again, be born again. Why must you take the idol from your father's house? If you keep it in your stuff, they will come for their property. Thank you, Jesus. And listen to me. The sad story of Rachel didn't end that well. Her father came.
Baba Rede,
that spirit of deception made her took the idol, put it in a camel's seat. Seat.
Joko.
And she sat on it. She said, let my father not be angry. His father sat everywhere. She said, I am observing my woman timing. That's
clear.
That's why I cannot stand
her.
She sat on her father's idol. And Jacob, her husband, already said, whoever took your idol must die. And God stamped it.
Ayas,
ayakaha. What you are carrying that is about to kill you. May you release it this morning.
No, right, you are your daddy.
That amen is too bad. Anything you keep now will kill you later. God told Saul, kill all the Amalekites. Open for me Isaiah 43 verse 12. He said, kill all the Amalekites. He spared King Agag. And that became a problem for the Jews in future to come. Come in your ore. Come in at your come in your ore. 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 Hallelujah.
Hey, you are.
Listen to me.
Egba me.
Listen to me.
Egba me.
Are you there?
Shewa me.
Please take your seat.
Eya kore joko.
I ask you again.
Mo ton bi yin lekan si.
What are you hiding?
Ki lo to di meru re?
In your stuffs.
Ki lo to di monu eru re?
Christianity is not a child's play.
Igbagbo ki se re mode.
Don't come to church and gamble.
Mo wa si le just go mo se yi je yo je.
I have declared and I have saved. Not that I would declare, I have declared. And I have saved. I have sold. When there was no strange God among you. Therefore,
you
are my witness. Seeth the Lord that I am God. Why are you not seeing as God in your life? Why is that others are testifying and you are looking at yourself?
Like
in spite of all your fasting and prayers,
it
looks as though God is not faithful to you. I ask you again, what are you hiding? In your stomach. You don't come to church to play church.
Oh, can I wasn't Justin? Come on, Peter, Jota, you.
You are in church to meet God.
Oh, one a lot of Latin, but a lot of Padini.
Christianity. When you feel form for exam for jam, they said religion. You say Christianity.
Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on,
you want to get a job? They gave you. They asked for your religion.
Oh, what share? What for? Any way? Go in that
name. That your name is Christian Chuku. Does not make you a Christian. I ask you again. Because anything you hide in your stuff will make you miss the rapture. Anything. Achan could not enter the promised land because of what he hid in his
talk.
You're not hearing
me.
I ask you, what are you hiding? In your spouse. You come to church, but you still corner a girl in your room. Your pastor didn't see it. Your pastor is not a judge. He's not the final rewarder. He will have given blessing to the wrong person. But the one that will judge at the end before him, even the broad darkness is like a
broad daylight.
What are you hiding in your stuff? It will keep you from the promised land. What are you keeping in your stuff?
I
went through my Bible. I saw some people that kept the right thing in their stuff. Let me start from the prostitute of Jericho. I see wonders. And it's moving me to tears. How prostitute will enter heaven and some pastors will miss it. Some
I see wonders.
The prostitute of Jericho.
I said, well, Jericho.
She, the senior of them all, that her house was on the wall of Jericho.
She will
have to pick her customers before every other prostitute. One day, she hid two men in her stuffs. These were men of God. And men of God are symbolic of God. They are God's representative and symbolic of God's presence. That's why the way you receive God's servant is the way you receive God. Jesus said, he that received you has received
me.
Whichever house or city you enter, and you are received, let your peace rest there. But if they reject you, it shall be worse for that generation than for Sodom and Gomorrah. Is somebody here? He said, whoever resists your voice has resisted my voice. And whoever resists my voice has resisted the voice of my Father. She received two men. She was a prostitute. But one day, she received two men. They were sent to Jericho as spies. She kept them in her store. Do you know because of that? I fear this God. And the spies told her, we are coming to destroy this city. Put in this house anything that is precious to you. And put down the red scarlet outside. Do you know Jericho fell by the finger of God? And yet when God pulled down
Jericho,
the house of Rehab was preserved. Everywhere fell. The finger of God speared Rehab and our family. The blessing is also generational. I went again because of time. I saw him. I saw a woman. She was called the rich woman of Shunem. Her husband grew old and she had no child. Her child is the next generation. But she received a prophet of God. Called Elisha. She kept him in her house. Gave him a place among her stock. And she became pregnant. She would have died without a sibling. She would have died without giving birth to the next generation. Ma supreketa supreketa ha. As I go on in this journey, I saw a slave in the Bible. His name is called Obed Edom. They were bringing the ark of God that symbolized the presence of God. As they got to the front of his house, a calamity struck. The son of the high priest who kept the ark for 20 years died. His father took care of the ark for 20 years. When God will say thank you, he killed one of his sons. I don't want to go into that mystery. Listen to me. And then David said, can I bring this ark to my house?
You
look at somebody that if he dies, it does not mean anything. If he's wasted, nobody will feel it. This slave of Edom. The word Obed Edom means the slave of
Edom.
They took the ark of God's
house.
And he kept it in his house. He kept the presence of God in his stuff. The Bible says everything in his house was blessed. These are people who permit the presence of God, and everything around them was blessed. Help me tap your neighbor. Ask them, what are you hiding in your store? Give me Isaiah 59. I'm closing verse 1 and 2. I am asking you, what is that thing that is taking the presence of God from you? What journey have you embarked on? Nothing is worth it. Any man can leave you. Don't let the presence of God leave you. Behold, the Lord's hand is not short. That it cannot save. Neither is ear heavy that he cannot hear. Verse 2. But your iniquities have separated between you and your God. If iniquity has stolen your blessing, it's small. But if he separates you and God, it is worse. Anything taking God from you is a devourer. Is a generational destroyer. Between you and your God, and your sins hid his face. The Bible says when his face is hidden, we are troubled. That he will not hear. For 5 days now we had a morning due here. On Saturday we ended it on the mountain. A lot of people came. Some of you came early in the morning, it wasn't convenient. Why must you do all that and have nothing to show? I have told you here, the love nature of God is his nature. He cannot change it.
Oh,
are you hearing me? His faithfulness, his righteousness, is from everlasting to everlasting. We cannot add to God. We cannot remove from him. He said, I am. I am. I am. That I am.
Emi ton je emi ni.
It means in the days of Abraham, I am. When it was the turn of Moses, I am. When Jesus came, I am. God is not past tense or future tense. He is the present help in the times of need. He is always there for you. He is the I am. Another of his name is Jehovah, the God that is God by himself. When the word was not here, he is the God. When the word came to be, he is God. When the word shall be no more, he will be the God. He is God by himself. You cannot add to him. You cannot remove from him. You are the one that should make your life right with God. I ask you again, what are you hiding in your store? It's better for me not to have a car if it will take the presence of God. It's better I die without money if it will take the presence of God. It's better to die solitary.
Ladawa.
If my relationship will take God from me. If my relationship will take God from me. It's better to die without being married. Are you hearing
me?
What are you hiding in your stuff? It's better to suffer here on
earth
if it will keep the presence of God. And I know in the Bible that if God be for me, if God be for me, can you help me with Deuteronomy 32 verse 30?
If God leaves a man, even if everybody support him, it's finished. If God leaves you, you are finished. 32-30. Thank you, Lord. 32-30.
Cast me not away from your presence, for Lord. Take not the Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me
the joy and joy of my salvation.
Oh, and rewrite spirit within me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take a seat. That was the song of David.
Oh, and David, yeah.
He made a mistake.
Oh, yeah, she say.
He was not afraid of losing the throne. For David, the most important thing is the presence of God. Because the presence of God has brought him this far. Many of us started well with God. The presence of God brought you this far. Now you are wiser than God. Samuel told Saul the king. He said, when you were little in your own eyes, and you look like you are nobody, he said, God took you and make you the king of Israel. Now you are wiser than God. David knew. All his life, he suffered on man of enemies. Enemies without. Enemies within. But the presence of God was his preservation. He knew. If God leave me, even if my throne is still there, I will eventually lose it. But if God is with me, and they take my throne from me, God will give it back to me. In Genesis 39, from verse 1, the Bible said, and God was with Joseph. That was all. And a slave boy in a strange land became prosperous. He got the throne. Not by politicking. Not by bending corners. But by the presence of God. Hallelujah. You must not be a foolish Galatian.
Oh, bro, Galatia.
Yes. Paul told them.
Paul is off.
Who has bewitched you? That you started with Christ. Now you are ending it in the flesh. I said that many of you used to fear God before. But now, your conscience is dead. And you are doing evils and it's not moving you. You are hiding things in your stuff. The Bible call it the accosting. That as long as you have it, my covenant for Joshua stand. But Israel will not be able to stand before their enemies.
Israel,
neither can my presence go with them. As long as those things are hidden in their stuff. Are you still there? How should one chase a thousand? One. How can one chase a thousand?
One.
You one. Dealing with 1,000. And two, put 10,000. How can two people chase
10,000?
Humanly speaking, it's not possible. Well, look at what the Lord said. Except their rock has sold them and their Lord has shut them up. When God leaves a man,
little problem we finish him.
Ìṣòro kékeré òní èèyàn ju ẹnìyẹn.
I told one of my son yesterday as I was speaking to him, he came to visit me.
Ìkànnà àwọn ọmọ wa kí mi náà ni mo wá bá sọ̀rọ̀.
And I was showing some materials on the laptop.
Mo bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ń fi àwọn kankan hàn lórí ẹ̀rọ ayélujára bí ajere.
And we saw one about tithes.
Àwọn arí kan tó sọ nípa ìdá mẹ́wàá.
I say, I know you don't pay tithes.
Mo ní mo mọ̀ pé ìwà ìsàdá mẹ́wàá.
He was laughing. He said yes.
Wọ́n rẹ́rìn-ín oníbẹ̀ ni.
I say you will learn this lesson in a very serious way.
Mo ní wọn akẹ́kọ̀ọ́ ìlànà tó lágbára.
I say you learn it in a very serious way.
Mo ní ọ̀nà tó lágbára wàá fi bá pàdé fún akọ.
I said me.
Mo ní èmi o.
I practice.
Èmi fi ṣíṣe.
That was a year.
Ọdún kan wà.
My wife and I, we didn't pay tithe.
Èmi àti àwọn mi àṣẹ̀dá mẹ́wàá.
We tried that year without paying tithe.
A gbìyànjú ọdún yẹn pé ká mọ̀ ṣẹ̀dá láì ṣẹ̀dá mẹ́wàá.
And we know what we suffered.
A mọ ìyàtá jẹ.
When we start giving our first fruit.
Bàtà rẹ̀ sí fi àkọ́sọ wá kalẹ̀.
That was a year we gave.
Ọdún kan àtà fi kalẹ̀.
Our years we gave. But that was a particular year we didn't give.
Àwọn ọdún kan àtà máa ń san, but ọdún kan wà tá àwa san.
Let us practice and even see what will come out.
Ẹ jẹ́ mọ jẹ́ kásìkásì ẹ̀wọ̀n tí ó jáde láti bẹ̀ pé àwọn san àkọ́sọ.
We now saw the difference between living under favor and living under labor.
Àwọn ọmọ ìyàtọ̀ tó wà láàárín pé gbé ní abẹ́ orí ọ̀fẹ́ àti gbé ní abẹ́ làálàá.
I don't need any man to tell me any lies anywhere.
Mi ò nílò ẹnikẹ́ni kó tó parọ́ kan fún mi níbì kankan.
I have practiced this word.
Mo ti gbé ọ̀rọ̀ yìí sì ṣe.
I told the minister yesterday, I saw you a preacher of the word and you are not practicing.
Mo sọ fún ọ̀ṣọ́ náà mo ní ọjọ́ olùwọ́ olùsọ àgùntàn tó ń wà sọ̀rọ̀ ṣùgbọ́n tí ò fi ọ̀rọ̀ tó ń wà yẹn sì ṣe.
I have practiced some of these truths that I know.
Èmi ti fi àwọn òtítọ́ wọ̀nyí tí mo mọ̀ sí ṣe.
If your rock forsake you.
Bí àpáta rẹ̀ bá kọ̀ sílẹ̀.
And I pray he will not leave you.
Mo sì gbọ́dọ̀ àpé kò yóò fi ọ́ lẹ̀.
Rock of ages, cleanse for me, let me hide. Let the world tell the glory from the beginning, be your seed, Let's rise up, everybody.
Thank you, brother.
Jehovah is saying expressly.
I said that son in pato.
What are you hiding?
You know, baby, Baba.
In your stuff.
In your life.
What are you hiding in your stuff?
You know, baby, Baba. Stand right.
Show them what you see. The heart.
Don't show them.
This is the first Sunday.
Èyí jẹ́ ọjọ́ ìsinmi àkọ́kọ́.
Ninth month.
Oṣù Ẹ̀kẹsàn-án.
There are a lot of prophetic word of God concerning this month.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ Ọlọ́run ló wà fún oṣù yìí.
Just like we have for every month.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí a ṣe máa ń ní fún gbogbo oṣù.
But God is not a man that he should lie.
Ṣùgbọ́n Ọlọ́run ṣe ènìyàn tí ó fi ṣèké.
I told the workers in the morning.
Mo bá òṣìṣẹ́ sọ̀rọ̀ lówùúrọ̀ yìí.
Even Adam.
Adamu pẹ̀lú ni Adamu.
In his fallen estate.
Nínú ipò ṣubú rẹ̀.
He said, I heard your voice.
Ó ní mo gbọ́ òun rẹ̀.
I was afraid.
Ẹ̀rù sì bà mí.
It means he still has some aorta of the presence of God.
Yẹni pé ó sì ní àwọn ìwàláyé Ọlọ́run pẹ̀lú rẹ̀.
But when God has left the man totally.
Ṣùgbọ́n bí Ọlọ́run bá fi ìyẹn lẹ̀ pátápátá.
Things that should have make him break himself in God's presence.
Ó tó ẹ kó wọ́n rà ẹ̀rì kalẹ̀ níwájú Ọlọ́run.
He will excuse it.
Yóò máa ṣe àwáwí kan.
He will reason it away.
Yóò ro ìrònú rẹ̀ yóò mú kó yàgò fún.
I want some of you who have heard the voice of God.
Mo fẹ́ tó pé ẹgbọ́n òun Olúwa.
And you know I'm not just guessing.
Tẹ́lẹ̀ sì mọ̀ wípé ìṣe kó bẹ́ẹ̀ yìí jẹ́ yóò jẹ́ ni mò ń wí.
That this is a word from God.
Pé ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run lè yí.
He's a man of God.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
I know I have a story.
Mo mọ̀ pé mo ní ẹrù kan ní ìpamọ́.
There are some secret things I'm keeping.
Àwọn ìkọ̀kọ̀ wà tí mo fi pamọ́.
And if God is giving a word like this, judgment is about to come. You want to release those thoughts. Wherever you are, just go on your
knee.
And tell him now. Lord, this is what is in my life. Just say it quietly, you don't have to shout. Tell him these are the things hidden in my stomach. In my secret room, I masturbate. I watch pornography. I do dirty things. I have some things hidden in my
stomach.
Tell it to God 1 minute. I don't have time today. Tell him, Lord, this is me. And this is my word. This is my word. I am responding to the word. I am responding to your word. Save my soul now. What is that thing? Handle it now. Before it puts your children in problem. Tell it to God. Tell it to God. Tell it to God. Tell him, Lord, I'm sorry. I know what is right, but I'm doing what is wrong. I am sorry. He has sent me to say it. And he said, as many as shall hear and respond. He said, I will show them mercy. And I will restore my presence to them. He said, I will restore the glory back to them. So keep Arusha Paradisa. Ile keparuse preneka sia. Ikapo supreketo siada. Ile ke suprene ke siada. Shena makasida bakarama masu breketa makasida.
All to thee I give it all to thee.
To you, Jesus, I surrender. to be my pleasant Savior.
Lord, to be my pleasant Savior.
My Father,
Papa,
I have delivered the word, and these have responded to you.
I went to dance.
You told me they respond, you will show mercy.
Father,
Baba, according to the word you told me, show them your mercy. Daddy, show them your mercy.
Baba,
whatever has stopped in their life, because your presence ceased, and they can't feel you like before. They fast, they pray, but they cannot see you like before. Father, I beg you in your name and by your word, show them your mercy
now.
Whatever the enemy has stolen because of this, restore it back to them. Father, we thank you. Give them a new heart, Lord. Give them a new spirit. Give them grace to stand. Grace to stand to the end. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Eyes
of prayer, and let's celebrate Jesus. That's the greatest thing that gives heaven's joy. Come and celebrate Jesus. I congratulate all of you. Now you are a brand new person. Go and walk in your liberty. Lift up your joy and give him praise.
Okay. Magnify the Lord.
Wonderful, marvelous are the works of my God.
Praise be thy name.
Wonderful, marvelous,
wonderful, marvelous are the works of my God.
Praise
be thy name.
Wonderful, marvelous are the wonderful,
marvelous. Father, I release the anointing for miracles.
Baba, ororo fun iyanu mo ti dale won lori.
I release the anointing for miracles.
Mo yonda ororo iyanu.
Miracles is supernatural intervention of God.
Iyanu ni pe on to Olorun nikan le se.
And for some of these people,
fun awon ni awon yi,
that admission will have to take a miracle.
Igbasile awon yen o lati pe fun iyanu.
For them to succeed, we call for a miracle. For them to get a job, federal government appointment. They don't know anybody, they know you, it will take your intervention. Doctors have tried, but their healing will take your intervention. Now I demand a release. The anointing.
If you are marrying,
for miracles.
When you know,
upon these lives. In the name of Jesus. Let there be miracle admissions. Let there be miracle jobs. Let there be miracle weddings. Let there be divine intervention. Let there be supernatural healing. This month, your needs shall be met supernaturally.
Amen.
It will not be a normal way of meeting your needs.
Amen.
For God will show up.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you glory.
Hallelujah.
We give you praise.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.